Hello and welcome to After Before Friday, week number 35, and the second in the monthly series of One Photo Focus. This month, all participants have the fun of editing this photo submitted by Manal Ali of A Single Shutter. Manal describes the photo as a foggy BP tower in London. So my goal in processing Manal's photo is to bring focus to this foggy tower. So with this image, I began in Lightroom, and the first thing that I wanted to do was to correct the perspective of the photo. And a good way to do that is to come down to the lens correction panel and hit enable profile corrections and then hit auto. And it's going to straighten and crop the photo a little bit, and this is the result that I have. This is a good base from which to start. I'm going to hit the crop tool a little bit more. I want to get rid of the extraneous detail. I'm going to bring this in. I'm going to unlock the perspective or the ratio, because I'm not going to be printing this picture, and pull this in here. And let's see which tool, the crop tool that I'm using is a variant of the rule of thirds. I think it's the golden ratio. And so the one of the intersection of this grid line is falling on the tower, though not exactly there, but I'm going to change the correct the crop angle, and that may pull it in a little bit more. I'm going to leave that there for now. Okay, from this point, I'm going to click done, and I'm now going to take it into Color Effects Pro, which I've been doing a number of videos on using Color Effects Pro, but that has become kind of my go-to staple in my post-processing flow at the moment. So once again, I'm going to right-click, hit my pull-down menu, come over and hit Edit in Color Effects Pro, and edit with the copy of the adjustments I just made, and wait while Lightroom exports this into the program and creates an empty TIFF file that will be populated with my changes in Color Effects Pro once I finish in the program. So here it is, and again, I'm going to X out of the filter that always shows up and start from scratch, and I'm going to apply from my favorites, or from the menu. I'm going over to my starred favorites, and I'm going to begin with a detail extractor, another one of my go-to filters, and I'm going to start on the strong large detail, and this balances light and tonality and brings out the details in the photo, and that's why I like it. You can see the different effects. You can go much stronger and create a much more stylized photo, but I'm trying not to go overboard here with Manal's photo. So I've got the strong large details, and all of these sliders are fine where they lay, but I want to change the effect radius, so from large to fine, so that there are more details are brought out in the smaller objects, and that creates more texture. So fine here, and now I'm done with this filter and I want to add another. So to do that, I click Add Filter, and I click on back, and I'm going to go to Tonal Contrast and click on the icon, and whoops, I inadvertently added going to that menu a filter. So to get rid of it, I just click X. Now I have to remember to click the Add Filter again, because if I don't and I just change filters, it will replace the detail extractor that I just did. So add the filter, and I'm back in Tonal Contrast. And for this, I'm going to stick with the default values, and you can see the difference in applying what it did when I applied this filter. You can toggle the effect on and off. And this also controls textures and detail throughout the image, and it just gave it more of a bump. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do, and this is something I create a vignette, and the way I do it in color effects is I go to the dark and light and center filter. So I'm going to click here. And I like to start with maximum depth and then tweak the sliders to my liking. Here, I want to change the shape of the filter from, let's see, this is number one is round. Actually, I'm keeping it. Number two is oval. But I'm going to keep the round and click on one. And I'm going to decrease the lumosity of the filter point. And I'm going to bring it down I'm sliding all over the place. Just to about here. The border lumosity, you'll see, has changed. I want to keep it as at this strength of minus 100. And then I want to change the center size because I really want to pull in the focus on the tower. Before I do that, I want to change the center of the filter. And I do that by clicking on Place Center, and I come over, and I'm going to click on about here. And you can play around with it till you're satisfied with the results. Let me just click here, and whoops. Click here a little bit more. Okay, well, we're going to leave it there. You can see that if I clicked over here, how it moves the filter. So I was just making, you know, little minor changes that weren't reflected much in what I was doing. So I've placed my center, and now the center size I want to decrease to really bring it in. So this is, I'll show you the before, and there's the after. And I'm going to try moving the center just a little bit over here, just a little bit more. Okay, I'm going to leave it there. And now I'm done with Color Effects Pro, and I want to bring it back into Lightroom. So I'm going to click Save. And the program will think, and it will then export this image or the information back into the empty TIFF file in my film strip in Lightroom. Look down here in the film strip, and you'll see, and there it is. So there are the changes. Now, as I pull it back into Lightroom, I realized that I wasn't quite finished. There were a few more tweaks that I wanted to make, and one is that I see that the crop angle is a bit off, and so I'm going to change that here. And you're wondering about these values is because I've already done this edit, and I'm just using the values from the edit that I had done before. So I'm going to click Done, and that straightens it better. The lines are better. Though this leans in a little bit, I'm okay with that. And I'm also going to open up the shadows using my basic panel. And I'm going to pull it up to about there. So it opens up and you can see more of the detail in the branches of the trees. Now I want to bring more clarity to the middle of the photo. So I'm going to use a graduated filter. And for that, I come over here and I'm going to click left click, and I'm going to pull the filter down to where I want to adjust it, and I'm going to bring it to about here. And then I'm going to come over to the effects, and I am going to increase the clarity to about here, and I'm going to increase the sharpness. And I bump the sharpness up to about here. So you can see before, and you can see after. And then I'm going to click Done. One other little bump that I wanted to do was just bring a tad more clarity to the foggy top of the tower. So I'm going to use my adjustment brush. No, actually, that's incorrect. I'm going to use the radial filter, and I'm going to place it over the tower. I'm going to hold down, left-click my mouse, and pull. And I'm just going to move until I get the shape around the top of the tower. And then the clarity, I'm just going to bump up just a little bit. Well, that's it. It was really not much, but I can show you. Let me click Done. Well, actually, let's see. Add radial filter, update filter. It's very subtle. I can see it on my screen and it makes me happy. So I'm going to, trust me, I'm going to leave it there. The last thing I'm going to apply is a little bit more of a post-crop vignette. So I will come down to the effects panel. And I'm going to do this. I have a number of presets that will automatically populate the fields in here, but I want to do this manually. And I'm going to start out by, I need to put a value in the amount so that the other sliders become available. I'm going to pull feathering all the way down to zero so that you will be able to see what I'm working with, and also pull the amount down. So that's what you can get, a very hard vignette when you feather, when you don't feather at all. But I'm doing this for purposes of display. So what I want to do is I want to pull down the midpoint, or I want to pull down, make this rounder. So I'm going to move the slider almost to the end. And the midpoint, I want to bring down to zero to really pull that filter in. Now, in the amount that I want to end up with is about in this range, and then I want to feather out the effect. So I'm going to pull it out to about here. So that's where I'm going to leave that. And as I look at it, the photo is a bit dark, so I'm going to come back up to the basics panel and I'm going to increase my exposure. And we'll leave it here. So this is the image. Let me go back to the before. There's the before. And there's the after. And here's my original. This was my original after. From here, what I wanted to do was then export this into, I wanted to create a black and white file. So I actually took this file and I edited it in Silver Effects Pro. And it's the same process. And I'll just show you, this is very quick because I only chose one preset with this file, and it is, let me find it and pull it down, it's my High Key 2 preset, and that is how I achieved the black and white version, which going in with a great color version, your base into black and white is really important first, and you can tweak from here, but this was the effect I wanted, kind of a pencil drawing. And then the same thing, you save, and it brings it back into Lightroom in the TIFF file, and there it is. So here's my original color, and here's the black and white. So there you have it. I hope you've enjoyed watching the video. For those of you watching it on YouTube, you can see more after before galleries on visualventuring.com and look for After Before Friday form. If you have any questions or comments, let me know either on YouTube or on my blog. And Manal, thanks for a fun, fantastic photo. It was it was challenging, but it was a lot of fun to work with. Thanks for watching, everyone.